Do you know he's an Oscar winner, right?
Yes, I do. Fanny and Alexander. Great, great film.
Have you seen it?
I have. I really
love
it.
Well, of course, you've seen, I mean, you've seen like 5,000 films, or?
Yes.
Did you never try to escape, to break out of the apartment?
We did at one point, and we sort of didn't have the guts to. We were attempting, like, should we do this now? Should we do it never? Because it was the kind of feeling where, you know, if you did something like that, there's no turning back.
You were the first one to do that, right?
Yes, I was. I went out with a mask, and then police came.
You put on a mask just not to be recognized?
Yeah.
That was when your father was out shopping or something?
Shopping for food, yeah. He could usually be gone about 3 hours or 4 hours at a time, so I figured now or never. I don't know. It wasn't a plan or anything. I don't know how I came to do what I did, but I decided to go out in a mask for a walk. And then apparently some people were scared of me in this white Michael Myers mask, and I wore sunglasses underneath. So you couldn't see my eyes at all, and people were like freaked out and like call the police, do something. And this is where I learned about keys opening your lobby doors, because I couldn't get in. So I was locked out. And then the police said, asked me to take the mask off. I did. They asked where I live, but I've never like spoken to strangers on my own, so I couldn't really answer them, and they thought I was psychotic or something. So they took me to where on my floor, 16th floor, and they told my mother that they're gonna have to take me to a hospital. They don't care what she says or what she does. And so my mother came with me. I went to the hospital, and I'm on kids my own age, teenagers, and it was like being in school or something out of a movie. I'd seen Mean Girls before, and that's what it reminded me of, having kids around my age and sort of this cafeteria. It's movie night, you have your own bed. Similar to a college vibe, but it was less joyful than a college.
But why didn't did anybody ask any questions? Did anybody knock on your door and say, hey, we're from child services, what's going on?
No,
here?
Because no one was aware that we were living in that sort of state. But some of our neighbors didn't know we existed.
Really?
Mm-hmm. We did a piece with ABC on 2020, and they interviewed some of our neighbors. And I didn't even know that they thought that, because I thought every time we went outside, some neighbors would see us, but apparently some neighbors moved out, and old ones moved out, new ones moved in. But a lot of people didn't even know we existed until then.
And from this first escape of yours, a lot changed back then, right?
Yeah, I came back. I told my father that I've had it with your rules. I've had it with your way of living.
It's very
Things
brave.
Are gonna be different.
It's very brave of you, probably.
I guess. But it was scary at first, because it was at that point where there's no turning back, the point of no return sort of thing, which is a structure in movies as well, funnily. And after I said it, I felt like a lion, part of like a leader of the herd or something. There's no going back. Now I'm in charge. You're no longer in command. Step down. And he did. And things were really different.
You were like his prisoners for so many years. Have you considered reporting him? I mean, he's still there.
I mean, after I came back from the hospital, they put child protective services on us. They put some agencies to come to our apartment and see how we were doing, and we didn't want to cause any trouble, because if we report him, they'll start putting my mother into it as well, and she would be on the spot as well, and it wouldn't be fair to her. So we just dropped everything and said, it's not worth it. Let's just get on with our lives and move forward and change things instead of trying to, I don't know, get revenge or something. It's not worth it.
Before you came here tonight, we did try to get in contact with him to give him a chance to share with us his version of what happened. And that was impossible, but we want to show a short clip from the movie where he sort of explains it. Take a look at this.
You know, we We are victims of the circumstances, you know, of life. So when we have understanding about that, then we don't blame, you know, we don't blame each other.
To me, this looks in a way like a person that won't take responsibility.
He was that person. I don't think he ever really grew like as an adult, because he was an only child, and his mother was always by his side, and so was his dad. But he never liked working. He never liked doing things for other people. He calls it being a slave to society or serving others. He likes the idea of being free, serving no one. He only answers to himself. And I guess he always stayed in that state of mind, and he still is in that state of mind till now.
Do you all still live together, the siblings?
Some of us do. My two younger brothers have moved out, and my older brother and I are planning to move to another part of the bureau in New York City.
So you actually, you live in the same apartment?
Yeah.
And is your father and mother, are they still there?
They are still there. Mm-hmm. We don't communicate with him or talk with him. We just ignore him as if he doesn't even exist.
So you live with him, but you don't talk?
Yeah.
Isn't that awkward?
No. It's quite easy, really. You completely, put a person out of your mind, or throw everything, the fact that he exists or that one person exists. Surprisingly, it's worked out fine. It was hard the first couple of times, because he's always running out and about, but we've been doing it for about 5 years now, so we've gotten used to it.
What about your mother? Is she...
Still talks with him, and they're still married, they're still together, and they still go to some places out together as well. I don't know why, really, but...
Now you're grown up yourself. You don't have children yet, but maybe one day you'll become a father.
Someday, maybe, yeah.
Maybe. I mean, what do you think of this kind of upbringing?
I would not recommend it. It is no way to raise kids at all. No. No matter what anybody says, even if they say, but there's a positive side to your upbringing as well, I go, well, that was luck, really. I would absolutely not recommend this sort of upbringing to anybody. It's no way to live.
Well, Kundal, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you very much.
Please welcome Kundal Angulo.